गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड एंड वेरी नाइसली यू हैव जस्ट गॉन थ्रू लेसन नंबर फर्स्ट एंड द इन द फर्स्ट चैप्टर वी हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट द हिस्ट्री, हाउ द हिस्ट्री इज इम्पोर्टेंट फॉर अस, व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट सोर्सेज टू नो अबाउट द हिस्ट्री. सो स्टूडेंट, इन द सीरीज ऑफ दैट वन, टूडे वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट द अर्लीस्ट सोसाइटीज. It means what you have learnt in the first chapter, that only we have to be taking the further topics. So in this chapter you will study about the early humans. How was their life and how they were living in their societies and how the things has been changed slowly. It means when there in the first chapter I explained to you the two types of history, prehistory and the history. Prehistory, the time when the human being was not educated, even though he was not having any kind of the sign and symbol of any kind of language. They were not able to express their own feelings. They don't know anything. So how the changes came in their life, how slowly they started to walk and move in a straight way, how in the present time we human being are moving. Okay, so this you are going to learn in this chapter. So first of all, student, you can see here the timeline. Timeline is too important. In the first chapter also we have talked about it. Here you can see first one is the Paleolithic age is written here, then Mesolithic age is written here, and here you can see the one line that is showing the BC and CE. This term also you are well aware, in the first chapter we have already talked about is the meaning of BCE and CE. Here you can see student, the Mesolithic age is very near to BCE and the gap is there 8000 BCE. But the gap is the Paleolithic age and the Mesolithic age is 10000 BCE, and here if you talk about that is the 5 lakh BCE before the Paleolithic age. It means the timeline is helping you something which age is near to us. So in this way we can understand the Mesolithic age was near to the BCE, okay, when before the birth of Jesus Christ. So now student, we can understand in the paragraph what it is explaining to you, the evolution from ape man to the modern man. So the meaning of evolution means the development. It means the meaning of development means the growth, how the things has been changed. The ape man, it means who was the early humans, how their life changed and how they became the modern man which we are nowadays today. Okay, so it is the story, the things has been started from the 1.5 million years ago when the human being first time appeared on the earth. How we came to know by the fossils, the study of the fossils. Okay, what is the remaining fossils, you know, the what is the remaining parts of the human particles and animals and the plants as well, many things are there. So about the study of fossils, this the proof and the evidence we got about the early humans, it means we human being were like an ape man before that one. Okay, and the humans were resembles, it means similar, दिखने में कैसे लगते थे वो, like the apes and the monkeys and called the anthropoids. They were known as the anthropoids. It means meaning man like animals. It means some they are just appearance, their look was like a man, but it was appearance of the animals also. So anthropoids took many years to evolve the modern man in this way. Slowly the evolution has started. The changes has been done in the ape man and the anthropodist, and they became the Homo sapiens, which now we are known as a Homo sapiens. So what were the characteristics of that time? It means the ape, jo langur hote the, bandar hote the, like the human early humans, how they were. There are the different characteristics, and we can understand. First of all, he could not walk straight. Okay, these are the further topic. We'll see the diagram. You are also aware about it. Previous classes you also have learned. Early humans were not able to walk straight. Second, he had a lot of hair all over his body. Okay, there was the more evidence of the hairs on their body. Even though they were not having the sense to think the whole properly. So we also have talked about it. They were not having any kinds of the sense. They were not, their brain was not developed. We know all the things we are controlling by the mind. So when they were not having the mind, so how they were able to complete the work? So they were not having any kinds of the sign of development. Okay, so this is some points which we are talking. Let's see what are the other points it given here. So now slowly what happened, he gradually learned to stand up but still walked with the shifting gait. Okay, he needs some kinds of the stick to take the support. With the time his brain became bigger while his jaws shrank considerably. It means we know the jaws part of the early humans was too big. Their head was too big. Teeth was too big. They were just looking like an app only. So slowly the changes took in their body. The things occurred and slowly they have, the changes came in their body. So now, just I have explained to you, eventually he became the resemble modern man and called Homo sapiens. So nowadays we are just, this is our scientific name, a human being, this is known as the Homo sapiens. So now slowly they started, what kinds of changes came? The changes came in their body, not only the physically, but the socially change also occurred. It means those were the early humans, their physically changes occurred. The things has been changed, but they became the more social creatures also. How? It means they started to now some dressing sense. They started to start some sign as a language. Slowly they started all the things. Okay, so it is given here, his lifestyle changed according to his environment. Now what is given here, good to know what the thing is explaining to you. If you have the best evidence, okay, so best evidence of we are getting from the Australia, found the old shaped rock like mounds in Australia. These mounds were actually fossils created by the microwaves around 3.4 billion years ago. So best evidence we got from the Australia, there are different kinds of mounds. Mounds means which are like jaise kuch dher sa lag jata hai from the soil when different kinds of the microorganisms, the microwaves, they made these kinds of the mounds, and there we got different kinds of the evidences from the like in the form of the fossils, and then we came to know about it. So I hope so whatever I have explained to you, you have understood what the main characteristics of early humans, how they were there physically, they were too different from nowadays. Okay, so and now in this figure also you can understand how the earliest people, they were moving. Okay, they were not able to walk straight. Then second, slowly he just started to woke up and started to walk some straight and slowly, okay, with the help of the stick. Now in the present form he came at last. Okay, so this way it means 200 million it means the slowly the changes they evolved has been started. Okay, so this is the things we have just came to know. This also is explained to you different names. Okay, Australopithecus, then Homo habilis, then Homo erectus, and then Homo sapiens. This we slowly with the human being got the name, the scientific name. Okay, in this figure also, here also you can understand, here it is given in your book, slowly how the human being, they have changed their life and slowly how they came to in the modern appearance. So that's why student, this we came to know from the different kinds of the fact, just we have talked in the lesson number 1, from the archaeological sources. When we don't have any written record, so from the different resources like the coins, like the pottery, utensils, whatever the remaining parts we got from any evidences, any excavations, any archaeological sites, so we came to know the people were living at that time. That's why the things is indicating by the Stone Age. ओके सो यू कैन सी द हेडिंग इज गिवन ये स्टोन एज. वाई वी आर जस्ट कॉलिंग दिस एज इज स्टोन एज. स्टूडेंट वी नो अर्ली ह्यूमन्स वर नॉट हैविंग एनी काइंड्स ऑफ द नॉलेज इवन दो दे डोंट हैव द नॉलेज ऑफ एनी काइंड्स ऑफ द मटेरियल्स. दैट्स वाई दे आर नॉट एबल टू मेक. दे वर लिविंग इन द फॉरेस्ट एंड देर वॉज द ओनली अवेबिलिटी ऑफ द स्टोन. दैट्स वाई दे वर यूजिंग और दे जस्ट यूज टू टेक द हेल्प ऑफ ओनली द स्टोन्स टू मेक ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ द टूल्स और इवन दो फॉर देर एनी काइंड्स ऑफ एक्टिविटीज टू किल द एनिमल्स और टू एनी टू डिग द फील्ड एनी अदर थिंग्स ओके फॉर वट एवर थिंग्स. सो बिकॉज दे डोंट हैव एनी अदर आइडिया हाउ दे कैन मेक द टूल्स. दैट्स वाई दिस एज इज नोन एज अ स्टोन एज बिकॉज ऑल द थिंग्स वर दे वर यूजिंग ओनली द स्टोन. So that's why student it is given in a paragraph also we can understand here what is given and explaining to you here. When man stopped living on trees he needed food to feed himself and also some implements to protect himself from the wild animals. So he stopped to live on the trees. So that's why what he started he used stones which were available in the plenty to make weapons. Thus historians have called this period stone age. So this already I have explained to you why we are just calling this age the stone age. Okay student, so you're supposed to be aware because first time you are learning the history in class 6 you this term supposed to be aware. Now we are dividing the stone age in three parts, especially first is the paleolithic age. This is paleolithic. Second is a Mesolithic and third is a Neolithic. So Paleolithic means paleo means old and thick means it is thick everywhere we can use this thick. Okay, so lithic means a stone. Okay, lithic means paleo means old, meso means middle and new means new and lithic means stone. Okay, so in this way we are having